Give me liberty or give me fewer signs. Tonight, the legal battle over a dancing statue of Lady Liberty rages on in Westchester.
Tonight, the township is threatening Lady Liberty's freedom, or at least the guy dressed up like her.
Now, Westchester says the costumed character is a sign and violates zoning ordinances.
WLWT News Size Karen Johnson is leading the way with our big story tonight at 5:30.
I know you've seen her, probably even honked at Lady Liberty too. You won't find her waving back outside Liberty Tax in Westchester.
I went into this looking at just the fact that Westchester would be a nice place to have a business, and it's kind of been a different story at this point.
Kyle Garth has been in a battle with Westchester Township ever since he opened Liberty Tax off of Tylersville Road 3 years ago. The township has banned Lady Liberty from waving on the street corner because officials say it violates the township's sign ordinance.
I would say that we've probably lost about a third of business just not being able to have anybody out there to wave. And then, the bigger issue here is being able to employ people who would like to have this position.
Westchester claims the waving Lady Liberty is a device, therefore a sign that doesn't meet zoning requirements.
Our view of the world is that the way the definition works is if someone puts on a costume in the context of trying to attract business, attract passerbys to a particular business, that person ceases being just a person in a costume and in essence becomes a device.
There's no merit to it. If they say a costume is a device, just as the judge's robe is a device, the UPS uniform is a device. Halloween costumes are a device, according to Westchester.
That was Karen Johnson reporting for us tonight. Judge Oney did not say how long it's going to take for her to make the ruling. However, she says she will make the ruling in writing. Also, if she sides with Liberty Tax, you will see Lady Liberty, we're told, back out there come January.